Hey, I'm Daniel DK coming at you for another episode of Overkill Quarantine Reviews. I'm here in my apartment because obviously the Banger Hangar is off limits. But huge shout out to Banger for keeping new content coming when it matters most and allowing us to fill from home. I've kind of been holed up here for however many weeks now with tons of canceled Exciter shows, canceled and postponed, listening to a lot of records, eating a lot of food and drinking a lot of coffee, just hanging out with my cat and kind of wondering when I can start going to record stores and metal shows and on tour again. To cope with the boredom, I've started doing some Twitch streaming where I play guitar and talk about metal and records and stuff like that. So if that interests you, you can hit me up on Twitch. It's at Daniel_DK, just like all my other social medias where you can catch up with me there, and we'll talk tunes. Also, if you somehow have not hit that subscribe button down below, we would love to get you to do that. It takes 0.01 seconds, and you will join over 250,000 other Metalhead subscribers building this crazy, crazy global metal channel. We also have a Patreon campaign, tons of cool content on there. Join up and get access to exclusive merch, blog posts, music recommendations, early access to videos, tons of cool stuff. Join the family, patreon.com/bangertv. All right, let's get to it. As a known thrash enthusiast, a lot of people often ask me, hey man, can you recommend any new school thrash bands? Why yes, yes I can. Yes, it's Colorado thrash juggernauts Havoc. They are back with their fifth release, appropriately entitled V. It's released today, May 1st, on Century Media Records. Now let's get to know the band. Havoc hail from Denver, Colorado, and play thrash that is true to the old school, but they add in a healthy dose of modern flair. They first have their earliest formations in 2004, go through some member lineup changes, put out some demos and EPs, and then in 2009 release their first full-length, Burn, and man, is it a sizzler. In 2010, they solidify their core lineup. It's the formative lineup that still exists today. It's David Sanchez, Pete Weber, and Reese Scruggs. Between 2011 and 2017, they put out three killer records together. I actually met them for the first time during that time when my band at the time played with them in Denver in their hometown. We crashed at their house. They were super friendly, super cool dudes, insanely talented at their instruments. And as a band, we all kind of looked at each other and knew that these guys were headed for success and leaving the rest of us behind in the dirt. Since that time, they've played with Metal Heroes, Anthrax, Exodus, Sepultura, Death Angel, and so many more all around the world. Now, that same core lineup since 2010 I've talked about is back for a brand new album with new bassist Brandon Bruce. We've got 11 new tracks for us to sink our ear teeth into. Right off the top, the first thing I notice is the album artwork. It's done by Eliran Cantor, who is responsible for tons of sweet artwork for a bunch of really cool bands, but specifically the last couple Testament records. The painting's a lot more complex than it looks at first. The way that the logo and the album title, kind of insignia, are blended into the art is very cool as well. It's kind of one of those paintings that you keep looking at and seeing little fine details that you didn't notice before. All right, the music. The album kicks off with a fade-in backwards guitar melody, and instantly I'm getting Ant Justice vibes, obviously, which is super cool, and it gets me stoked for the record. Metallica fans, this is not the only Metallica Easter egg on this album either, so do yourself a favor and have a listen and pick them out. And the first thing that I notice is the production. Like we've come to expect with Havoc, it's a very clean, tight, and compressed-sounding production in all the right ways. The tones are rich, the drums are mixed perfectly, David's vocals are hella angry and abrasive, but they come through crystal clear. The record sounds amazing in good headphones, it sounds amazing cranked on my stereo. That's a big check mark on audio from me. Right from the get-go, we're treated to an elevated level of riffing. These are fast and tasty classic sounding riffs, and the speed, both on the picking and the drums, is a very, very impressive stuff. The signature Havoc gang vocals kick in the verses of Post-Truth Era. Man, I get goosebumps, honestly. It's something that Havoc does a lot on their records, is they kind of nail the old school thrash gang vocal. Their voices all just sound really cool together. Whatever they do in the studio to layer it, it sounds huge. These gangs are all over the record, and they always cut and punch perfectly. It's obvious that these guys wear a lot of their influence on their sleeves, as most proud thrashers do, but there is an undeniable Megadeth influence, irony, in more than one way on the record. There's some rock chop riffs that totally sound like Countdown and After Countdown era Megadeth. There's also this super awesome Rust in Peace-esque guitar melody line. It's in the chorus of Fear Campaign, and it's like I'm just having total like Marty and Dave flashback moments. While majority of the riffs on this record are super fast and have me picking up my jaw off the floor, and literally my wrist is hurting just listening to them, this band isn't always just about speed, and this is one thrash band that sounds really, really awesome when they slow it down. There's these killer mid-tempo riffs like in the songs Ritual of the Mind and Panpsychism that instantly have you like headbanging and rocking a steady stomp. There's tons of cool mid-tempo stuff. It doesn't always have to be blistering fast with Havoc. As well, there's also this really cool one-minute interlude on the record, very reminiscent of like Roots era, Sepultura, percussion. Another standout riff, absolutely standout moment on the record, is the start of Betrayed by Technology. It's got this really weird, disjointed, and just uncomfortable sounding technological riff that perfectly goes with the song title, that would even make the members of Voivod proud. Stuff like this just further goes to prove how versatile this band is, tempo and groove-wise. Alright, let's talk leads. Whoa, Reese Scruggs smokes. That is the only way to put it. He's always been great at guitar, we've always known he was awesome, but he's really stepped up his game and spice levels on this record. There's just so much structure and flavor in his note selection and phrasing, standouts, the trembar solo in Fear Campaign, that face melter on Phantom Force, and those tasty licks in Merchants of Death. There's definitely something to be said about the rhythm tracks as well. David and Reese both playing insanely awesome classic thrash riffs throughout the whole record, like the closer on Don't Do It or the opener on Phantom Force, like stuff like that. This is just classic thrash embodied into a riff. There's also definitely something to be said about David's ability to play said riffs and sing the way he does at the same time. I think he does it just as good as the Mega Daves and Chuck Schuldiners of the world, rest in peace. David's got a few screams on this record that, like, rattle my ribcage. Dude sounds pissed. I've always liked that Havoc has used the bass as a versatile instrument, like it is. They don't dumb it down to a four-string guitar like a lot of thrash bands that play with a pick do. The bass on this record is mixed very dynamically. It's pushed to the forefront when it needs to be, and it's pulled back when it needs to be. The tones change, the levels change. That's how it should be with something like bass. I'm a huge fan of the funky, heavy bass-driven moments on the record, like Cosmetic Surgery and Panpsychism. I totally think that that style of like funky bass should be used more in metal in general. Pete Weber, one of the best in the biz, speed, accuracy, and just straight skills. His drums sound massive, and his riffs are just straight up innovative. Alright, so clearly I really dug this record, but what about this record doesn't quite do it for me? I find that the lyrical content and the way it's delivered on this record doesn't always quite hit the mark for me. I love thought-provoking lyrics, I love controversial lyrics, I like when things are politically charged, but sometimes I just feel like I'm being yelled at in a very literal, wake up sheeple, kind of way. This isn't totally something new for Havoc, this is something that existed a lot more on Conformicide, but I just don't think it's quite there yet. On a much lesser note, There's also just what I like to call some throwaway or placeholder riffs that I don't think stand up to the rest of the record. Very, very minimal, and I'm just getting picky now. All right, so let's throw all that nerdiness and thrash majesty into a verdict. Overall, Havoc's fifth release, V, is a very, very well-crafted and excellent-sounding thrash record. Fans of the old guard will have no problem cranking this up and putting it into their regular rotation. For fans of the new school and listeners who prefer a more modern or technical approach, there's also tons of stuff here for you. The aggression, technicality, and spirit is all there with Havoc V. There's just still room for musical exploration and growth, which I love, and that's why I'm stoked to give this record 4 out of V skulls. All right, it's shout-out time. This is almost as exciting as the review. These are releases that have either just come out in the last month or just about to drop that I think you gotta check out. Huge riffs and bassy stony grooves. Canadian trio Pale Mare released Pale Mare 2 on Seeing Red Records on April 3rd. These are some of the best thick tones and modern heavy tunes I've heard in a while. Also April 3rd, Immortal Bird singer Ray debuted her self-titled EP with her new solo project, Errant. It's spacey, it's chaotic, and I love it. April 10th, Canadian traditional heavy metal defenders Traveler released Termination Shock on Cruise del Sur. Trust me, stop what you're doing immediately and listen to this record. April 17th, straight out of Tel Aviv, Israel, Venomous Skeleton released Drowning in Circles on Everlasting Spew Record. It's some of that super dark and eerie sounding death metal. You're gonna love it. Finally, May 22nd, the highly anticipated release from Indiana heavy metal doom dudes Wolftooth entitled Valhalla comes out. Thanks again for joining me for another episode of Overkill Reviews Quarantine Edition from my living quarters. Tell us what you thought of this record. Tell us what you thought of some of the shout-out records. Just leave a comment. We want to hear from you. Oh, and you get to meet my cat. One sec. Wow. This is Kitten. Wave bye, Kitten. Bye.